But then when I was in 2011, February 9th, Wednesday, when I was studied at the University of California in Irvine, among the other things they did was a CAT scan, and they found out that mine and a few and the other people who they studied with this, parts of our frontal lobes are almost twice the size as the average person. So I thought, okay, I might have worked at it, but it came naturally at the same time.
Okay. Were you, it seems to me like school must have been a breeze for you, right? Traditional, like grade school and high school and all that. You because if you can remember everything, you don't have to do your homework.
Well, it was kind of a mixed blessing in school because, of course, anything that required memorization was a breeze for me. But sometimes, like I'd have so much many facts and information going on in my head that it would be a little tough to pay attention to what was going on right in front. So I was still good at school, but I did have to do homework.
Okay. It's just, you know, it's a fascinating thing because when we hear about things like this, and they used to call it a photographic memory, that's not necessarily an accurate description, is it?
No, like I read Harry Lorraine's book years ago, and back even when he partnered with the basketball player Jerry Lucas, and
right,
that's all kind of eidetic memory. What I have is kind of unique. They've only discovered maybe a couple hundred people in the world between three countries who can do this. Well, the technical term is hyperthymesia, and the university calls it a highly superior autobiographical memory, but me being an author, I prefer to just say superior autobiographical.
Now, that's incredible, man. In my introduction, I said this could be a burden. Has it ever felt like a burden to you?
Yes. Well, that's how I got interested in studying psychology, and because not only do I retain the episodic, the details of the memory, but I also remembered well the emotions from each memory. So that would be pretty cool, remembering vacations, fun times with friends, dates and all. But it was a burden when I'd remember bad days at school or work and romantic breakups when I got older and that. So I wanted to learn how to release. I knew I was never going to let go of the episodes, the memories, but I wanted to learn how I could at least get rid of the feelings, emotions from the bad memories.
Yeah, that was, you know, when you started to talk about it, that was the first thing that popped in my mind, because I do, when the bad things especially, the emotional hard times in my life, I remember them and I relive them in a very, very strong, connected way. It's almost like time travel in a way, but bad time travel. But I'm just curious, when this happens to you, are you in control of it? Can you if there is a incident, like you're remembering something really bad in your life and you're starting to feel, can you turn it off?
Well, yes, there's ways to turn it off.